applaud me. Apparently, I'm not welcome in the new studio. I have been relegated to the barn. Because apparently, in this new brave world that Ferguson has got himself a big fancy studio, no one is allowed to say the word. So if you want to talk like that, you have to come in the barn. Or as I call it, barn. It's just an expression. Do you know what? This horse is creeping me out a little bit. You used to be sort of a friendly, dancey figure, and now you're sort of menacing, sort of horsey serial killer. Look at me when I'm talking to you, bastard. Look at me. Why won't you look at me? What the wrong with you? Is there anyone in there? Actually, no, it's a serious question. Is there anyone in there? It's frightening, that thing. Anyway, look. Sorry, my throat's a bit croaky. Because I'm allergic to horses. And, half horses. What? Well, yeah, all right. There's someone creeping up behind me, showing me how long I've been talking. Here. Talking. Let me tell you, I'm not a fan of the new studio. I don't like it. I don't like the creepy new horse. But I'm prepared to put up with it for one thing: lettuce. That's a slang word, money.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com for a free rate quote. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
That's great! Thank you, everyone, thank you! This has made the new studio worthwhile. Please sit down, relax, don't worry. The chairs are new. There is no gum underneath most of them. Nothing has been peed on. Most things have not been peed on. Everything's been peed on. It's a great day for America, everybody. It is, though, it is. You know that NASA, they announced today that the Mars rover transmitted its most spectacular photographs yet. There's three brand new panoramic shots of Prince Harry's ass. Worth the taxpayers' money. It's a very bad day for Prince Harry again. The newspapers in Britain have published his naked pictures and they've received over 4,000 complaints, but also over 1 million letters of support, all from Elton John. Do you know that the other person that everybody's talking about today is Harry's grandmother, the Queen of England, Her Majesty the Queen of England, Elizabeth II. She was photographed driving an SUV and wearing a hoodie. I know, we've got a picture, we didn't touch this, this is real, look at this. Look at that! If you look at the photograph, it seems like she's driving the inside a public lavatory. You see that? It's all part of our new hip-hop alter ego, 50 pence.
My hopes! In my tea, I take sugar lumps.
Anyway, it's a great day for America, but also a scary day, because there's a big gust of dangerous hot air is bearing down on our shores. That's right, it is the first night of Madonna's American tour, tonight. I love that British singer, he's my favourite. Hello, Gavna. We're living in a material world. She's starting her tour in Philadelphia, which makes sense because both rose to prominence in 1776. And during the world tour... Wait. That's actually very bad news for Madonna. I made a Madonna joke and then you kind of went, ah. That's the worst thing that can happen. Because if you just went, hey, that would be like, no, but no. During the world tour, Madonna has been very vocal about this Russian band, Pussy Riot. That's what they're called. Can we say that? Yeah, all right. It's because of the new set we can say. On the old set, we would have had to say, ooh la la, Riot. Now, if you don't know what this band, and this is what they're called, I'm sorry, that's what they're called. They're called Pussy Riot. If you don't, you know, get with the times, Grandpa. They're an all-female rock band. Like Coldplay, and the... That's right, I'm calling you out, talented twinks. Anyway, this band, they're from Russia, and the three members are locked in a Russian prison. Madonna's really up in arms about it. We got a picture of Madonna when she played Russia. This is what she did. Look. Yeah. You got to make sure you read both arms. But she is now so buff, she is renting out her arms as billboards, which actually is an idea she stole from me. Do we have a picture of from my Russian tour? There you are. Gotta make sure you read both arms. Anyway, here's why this band are in trouble. They set up in a Moscow cathedral to play a protest song about Vladimir Putin's ties to the church. Not his ties. They don't mind his ties. It's his ties to the church. And after 40 seconds, the security guards threw them out. And then Putin's henchmen tracked three of them down and arrested them and sentenced them to prison for 2 years with a charge of hooliganism. Is that even a crime, hooliganism? It's like being charged with tomfoolery. Or you're going to prison for shenanigans. And this, you know, this story about Pussy Riot has angered a lot of American politicians. Well, one, Clinton. I have no idea what this is about. But it sounds like something I need to get involved. Read both arms. The whole thing is very scary because it seems like Russia is returning to the old ways. If you don't agree with Putin, you get sent to the gulag. Now, women wouldn't have been arrested if they were singing a song about how much they love Putin. Oh, Putin, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Putin! Come on, Jeff! Hey, Putin!
Oh, Putin, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Putin!
Luckily, this is America. We can sing that ironically. Maybe they should have sang a song about the fact that when Putin got elected, he had 140% of the vote. And some people are saying that some Russians are claiming that Putin's election was rigged and he has no legitimate claim to power. And these Russians, they are called missing. He's really working hard to be seen as a badass. So you get that picture of Putin, that one we had? Yeah, look at that guy. You shouldn't go around like that, posing with pictures with your shirt off. Who do you think you are, Prince Harry? Knock it off! And they were, when they were sentenced in Moscow, there was a huge protest. And one of the protesters was Garry Kasparov, the chess champion, who got roughed up by the police. It's not a joke, it's just true. It's news. You're getting news here. Russian news. Anyway, you don't want to mess with a chess championship. A chess champion, what do you call them? Chessmen? Chesters? What do you call a guy who plays chess all the time?
Chessy,
yeah. You don't want to mess with a chessy. You'll wind up with a rook where the sun don't shine. That's what'll happen. They actually arrested Kasparov. I don't know why they arrested him. He's just a pawn in their game. Wait. Did you laugh in sympathy because they ooed?
Oh.
That's bad about Madonna, isn't it, when they went, oh. Because you know what comes after, oh, bless her. You know what, Jeff? I gotta tell you, Secretariat is freaking me out.
You're very creepy, man.
Look at just... You know what we should... We should have some creepy music.
Yeah,
you got any creepy music for Secretary? All right. That's really frightening.
That is weird, man. That's creepy.
Do it again, just a little bit. All right, that's enough.
Do it again, but no, with Morgan Freeman. Morgan Freeman narration.
All right, then, okay. Do it again with a Morgan Freeman narration.
Secretariat waited patiently by the barn door, fondling himself, waiting, watching.
Stop! You're freaking me out! You're freaking me out! We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Are you ready, Jeff?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Putin.
Sing it with me, Jeff.
Oh, Putin, you're so fine.
You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Putin.
Hey, Putin.
I don't know. Are we settling into the new studio now? We enjoy. Is everybody okay with it? I got a lot of emails and tweets from the folks at home. When I say a lot, I got one. It was from CBS. Apparently, I'm not allowed to say
crikey
anymore. So that puts us in a bit of a quandary. Right, Jeff?
It's going to be a shorter show.
It's going to be a shorter show. All right, what time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
Well, it's Tweet Mail time, brought to you tonight by Putin's Antacid. Stomach infiltrated by the KGB, killer gas and bloating. You'll be tooting with Putin.
Emails. Email time again. All right, this is from Frankie in Malton, New Jersey. You ever been in
Yeah,
you got a little place there, swimming,
get naked,
beads and
all right.
Says, hi, Craig and Jeff. My girlfriend says I spend too much time on the internet and watching TV and should be spending more time with her. I'm not so sure. What do you think? I don't know. Jeff?
I mean, what's wrong with his girlfriend, man?
What do you think, Secretary? All right. I think you should spend more time with your girlfriend. What do you think?
Yeah, I think
so. Wait, you're not yay! All right, don't spend any more time with your girlfriend. Spend more time on the internet looking at pictures of women you can't have sex with. All right. This is a... People respond to meanness a lot better, don't they?
People shouting now in the audience.
I know. What the hell is that? Knock it off. You know why? Because we spent all our money getting the studio done. We have no security anymore. People just wander in off the streets and yell stuff. It's like my first marriage. Oh, wait, that was me. This is from Larry in Los Angeles, California. Now, I don't know, you ever been there, Los Angeles?
Oh, yeah, love it. Love it there.
You see, Larry is he's an owl.
Who?
Oh, yeah, very, very good, Jeff. That's excellent work there. Take the rest of the week off. Larry says, Craig, here I come. Looking forward to seeing your show tonight. And it's from Larry King. It's from Larry King. He's not an owl at all, of course. He's on the show later. It's a tweet from Larry King. Yeah, wait, don't applaud. Lots of people know how to tweet. It's not a thing. Larry's got a great amount of great achievements in his life. He brought CNN to its knees. He didn't actually. CNN was worth an ooh la la when Larry was there. I have to add my ooh-la-las now, but we can't even afford to put ooh-la-la in. When I say...
Groggy!
It stays...
Groggy!
Oh, it doesn't? Oh. Anyway, it's from Larry King, so that's great. This is from Savannah in Montgomery, Alabama. You ever been down there?
Oh, yeah, love it down there.
I like it in Alabama. I like it, I like it down there.
You like it down there?
I like it down there.
Yeah.
I like it down there because, you know, I like it going down there because it's hot, you know.
Yeah, gets a bit musky.
Yeah, it can get a bit musky, but I like it down there. I feel like, you know, it's a good feeling down there.
Then also you like Alabama, right?
I do like Alabama too, yeah.
Yes, thank you.
Savannah says, Dear Craig, what's behind the red curtain? Is it the big cash prize? Behind the curtain? You wait with nothing yet? Well, you know what we should put behind the curtain? A blow-up... Oh, does it open? Oh, wow, look at that! It's a room full of nothing! You know what would be awesome? If, like, now you pulled it back again and there was something there. But that won't happen. Yeah. You got some music for the curtain? Yeah. Now, here's what we should do. When that music plays...
Yeah.
You know, I've just noticed this rhinoceros over here as well, but...
Hell, man.
That rhinoceros should talk.
It should maybe talk like Morgan Freeman.
No. No, we got enough of that already. Right, we're out of time, so we've got 4 seconds left to do all these emails, so we'll do them. All right. This is from Marianne in Kansas City. Everybody in Kansas City?
Yeah, sure,
Dear Craig and Jeff, my husband won't go to the dentist. He keeps cancelling. How can I convince him he's got to go? You can't. Send him to Britain. This is from Zach in Tennessee. I don't know if you can tell, Zach's a cockatoo. He says, Dear Craig, I hate the new studio, and by hate the new studio, I mean it's awesome. I don't understand you. This is from Jenny in Amarillo, Texas.
Oh, yeah, sure, yeah.
Hi, Craig and Jeff. Do you have new catchphrases now that you're in the new studio, or is it the same one? No, same one. That sounded dirty.
There goes my penis.
All right. This is from Chris in ISU, which I get, what's that? Like, he's intensive care? He's in hospital? What? Dear Craig, I'm thinking of studying abroad in Scotland. Should I?
Yeah.
And finally, this is from Mark in Savannah, Georgia. It says, dear Craig and Jeff and Larry. He's not here yet. Do you have any barbecue tips for me? I've got a lot of guys coming over this weekend. That's really one for you, Jeff, isn't it?
I've got no tips, but send me the address.
Yay! We'll be right back, everybody. Guest tonight is a legendary talk show host. He's got a new show, Larry King Now. That's a clue to who he is. It airs on Hulu. What is that? Hawaiian network? It's on the computer. All right, we'll take a look at this. Please welcome the great Larry King. Yeah. Cool. What do you think, Larry? New studio, what do you think? Do you like it?
I am very impressed.
Do you really?
This is just, it's spacious. I love the wooden colors.
Wooden colors?
I love the fake fireplace.
It's not a fake, that's a real picture of a real fire.
The last time I was on this show, I had to guess what was hidden in your box.
Yes.
And I guessed a baby rhino. You put it on the wall.
That's not a baby rhino, and it's not a rhino. I don't want people to get upset. I said, no, it's not a real rhino. It's not. We didn't hurt
what
a rhino.
Is it?
It's made of kittens.
You know, I want to tell you something, Ferg.
What?
You can make it a beautiful studio and a beautiful set and a wonderful surrounding.
Are you going to break into a song? Because it sounds like you're going to break into a song. You know, let me tell you something. It goes a little something like this.
This is still.
Okay.
The sicker show on television.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I like the thing. Yeah. Hey, I have done one thing, though. I kind of stole this from you. Look what I've done. It's a tribute, Larry. It's a tribute
to you.
Why
don't you take the jacket off?
No, man.
Well, you gotta... Yeah,
I don't want to look like a fool.
Don't do that to a Jew.
What?
Don't do that. Don't do that.
What? Okay. I think you look great.
I feel great.
Do you really?
Yeah, well, I'm back working again. It's...
Yeah, you're on the Hulu now. So you do that in Honolulu?
Come on.
Did you just give me a sympathy? That's like...
Yeah. By the way, I taped Craig today. He's on my show next Tuesday night on Hulu.
Yeah, it's a big show.
You're going to enjoy it. It's on the internet. It's terrific.
Yeah,
but we have a new company called Aura TV. My wife was really the founder. She came up with the idea.
Your wife has her own internet company?
No, it was pretty much hers. No, wow. It's in partnership with Carlos Slim out of Mexico.
Carlos Slim?
Who could
buy Is he the guy, the Dos Equis guy?
What? The what?
You know the guy, the most interesting, you know, I don't always drink beer, but when I do. Is that him?
No, Carlos owns the beer company.
Oh, he's the richest man. Richest man in the world?
No.
Do you hang out with him?
He's my partner.
What do you mean he's your partner?
I got a piece of the company and he put up the heat.
So you, are you one of the richest men in the world then?
No.
You're worth a little money.
A little.
You got a little
but
money.
But not that league, come on. Not in your league, come on.
My league? In my league, I've got a robot skeleton, a rhinoceros made of kittens, and a serial killer horse. That's all I got.
You got a good point.
Yeah.
Anyway, we came up with the idea for Aura TV, a new network on the internet. I host the first show. We're going to be doing other shows.
And it's your old format then? It's your, you know,
well,
talking
except,
to...
Yeah, except we have a beautiful setting. We have beautiful studios. It really is nice.
You got girls marching up and down?
No,
hot, hot girls marching up and down?
We don't have a horse.
Well, you
don't have girls.
You've got to get with it, Larry.
Robot.
That's the way things are now.
I guess maybe you're right.
You've got to have really attractive ladies marching up and down.
And another thing we're doing.
Yes.
In cooperation with... This is...
What, you have to go to the bathroom?
Why do I come here? Why? Anyway, for $540.
Yeah. That's the same as I get for every show.
We made a thing with YouTube. This is going to be great. On the last two nights of the convention, tomorrow night and Thursday night,
right.
I will be on following the convention, live, streaming live.
Screaming.
On YouTube. Streaming.
Screaming.
Streaming.
Streaming.
On YouTube.
We're right. Have, streaming.
We're going to do.
You going to do that? You going to do
political shows.
That's not political.
We'll be on after the Democratic convention. We'll be on after
knock
the
debates. Knock it off, buddy. Just knock it off. So you're still involved then?
We'll be on election. In other words, I'm involved.
I understand.
It's nice to be involved.
Yeah, again. Well, listen, I tell you what, since you left CNN, boom, they're kaput. They're gone. Nobody cares. No, I'm telling you, Larry, the only thing people watch CNN for now is to see when you're coming back.
Well, that's a nice...
Have they said to you, let's have you back then, Larry?
No.
Ah, oh, those bastards.
Yeah. Well, I had a 25 and a half year run.
That was great. Yeah. I'm telling you, well, it was used to be my routine whenever I went anywhere in the world. I've told you this.
So nice.
You go into the hotel room, you turn on the TV until it gets to your show, take my pants off and watch whatever. And that's the people the world over do that. They get to CNN, they find you, they go, okay, Larry's on. You take your pants off and you go. And that's how you relax in foreign countries.
Did you ever fool around while I was on?
Yeah.
Did it end?
Depended on who the guest was.
Not with Rickles.
No, especially with Rickles. Yeah.
To add to the ambiance, did it help?
It worked for me.
I like
it. Don't touch me, man. You're creeping me out.
I like this. What is that on that tie? You got amoeba?
That's not amoeba. It's paisley. That's a paisley tie.
Yeah, but the figures are amoebas.
That's not amoebas.
They're amoebas.
That's not amoebas.
What are they?
It's a design paisley originally.
It's an amoeba.
I'm part of a charity. It's my charity tie. Save the amoeba. We're very worried because a lot of people want to save the whales, but the whales are eating all the amoebas, and that's what we're worried about.
I'm going to join you.
Yeah, good. Yeah, we'll take a break. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
We're back
already.
Yeah, we're back. Yeah, it was a short commercial break.
Oh, you don't wait for the commercial. We just go right back on the show. I like that.
No, the commercial.
Some shows you got to wait 2.5 minutes.
No. These shows are live. This show is extra specially fast live.
We are really moving tonight.
This is messing with the commercials move faster on CBS. That's why we're the number one network. You know what I think is interesting about audiences? That made no sense, but included the phrase, we're number one, so they just applaud. Yeah. Oh, we're number one!
This is, it proves Pavlov's theory, right?
He had a theory about CBS?
No.
I think these dogs will enjoy CSI Miami.
He had a little fun there with the girls in Moscow, huh?
Oh, yeah. You ever been to Russia? I love Russia.
I love
fascinating
Moscow's
country.
Great.
A great place. You ever been to St. Petersburg?
No.
Oh, that's an amazing
You know
amazing
who invited
place.
Me to St. Petersburg?
Tsar Nicholas I?
No, the president. The man you were kidding about.
Putin?
Yes.
Oh, if he invites you, you got to go.
I'm going to go.
Or else.
I don't think he'll kill me if I didn't go, but I'm going to go. He invited me.
He might.
He was a very good guest. He's a very good guest. He's a very interesting guy.
We should have him on the show.
All right.
He's the czar of all the Russias. Of course he's interested.
He's not a czar.
Oh, no. Isn't he, Larry? Isn't he?
If I got him for you, would you?
Well, first of all, apologize for the monologue and then ask him if he wants to come on.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, well, you know, it's America, free speech.
Well, we had our, remember the Dixie Chicks? They tried to ban them when they sang, they spoke out against George Bush. They didn't put him in jail.
Right.
It was a big uproar.
Yeah, but no one said you can't say it. In fact, I distinctly remember George Bush saying they're allowed to say it. It's
that's
America.
Right. Well, they are. It's America. That's right, right, right. Great. Right. Free speech.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
It's like when you work for a charity. It's free speech.
All right, Larry, we're out of time. So what do you fancy? You want an awkward pause, a mouth organ? You want to go for the big cash prize, which I have to tell you now is $7.50 because of the renovations we had to cut back.
You know, I have my bag home with the $50 of quarters.
Well, then
sometimes I forget to take it with me and I get a ticket.
Well, this is $7.50 in nickels.
In nickels?
In nickels.
I'll go for that.
All right, then. $7.50 in nickels. What time is it, Shamus David?
It's time for the big cash prize.
All right.
I'm a little nervous.
Now, don't be worried about it. I'm just going to ask you a question. If you get it right, you're going to win the prize, okay? The question is, Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. Here's the question. What is trichology? Is it C, the study of hair?
Give me the other two choices.
Why? I gave you the right one. What the hell do you care?
C, the study of hair.
Here's the right answer! Next guest is a very funny comedian. Her podcast, It's Your Journey, Boo, is available on the iTunes. Please welcome Michelle Buteau. Michelle Buteau.
Hey, everybody. I have some great news, guys. I just got married. Hey, thank you. Yes, 2 years ago, the check just went through. We had a really charming wedding in Miami in July because it's 40% cheaper to get married during hurricane season. You're welcome. And when I first got married, all my friends were like, damn, girl, let me see your ring, boo. Let's see that bling. Let me see that diamond. I'm like, what? I have a very simple wedding band, okay? Because I am anti-diamond. I saw this crazy documentary about these kids in Africa. Just kidding, he's broke. Yeah, white gold is forever. For real, the bigger the ring, the shorter the marriage, Kim Kardashian. My parents are so cute. When I first got married, they had all this advice for me, and rightfully so. They've been married for 46 years, which is amazing, because they're both jerks. And it's not like they don't believe in divorce. They totally do. They're just really competitive. My mom's like, when are you gonna die? And my dad's like, it's my money. You die first. And I'm like, damn, can't we just have Christmas? My mom gave me this really cute piece of advice. She said, you know what, Michelle? Never go to bed angry. Have you heard this before? Never go to bed angry? Yeah. I never heard it. I was like, Mom, I need my 8 hours. We'll work it out. And my dad told me, you know, the secret to a really long, healthy marriage is having a good imagination. That's how your mom looks so beautiful to me all these years. Have you heard that one? But I love my man. I totally trust him. I had to. He's Dutch, and I couldn't Google Translate all his emails anymore. And I love his accent. I feel like people with accents like make anything sound sexy. Like when I first started dating him, he's like, oh, Michelle, do you want a sandwich? Do you want a sandwich? I'm like, yeah, I'm not even hungry, but I want a sandwich. He's like, Michelle, do you want a sandwich with fresh herbs? I'm like, fresh herbs? I feel like a lady. But now 2 years later, I'm like, man, can you conjugate something, please? I don't know what you're trying to say, but I need subtitles right now. I is. That's not proper English. This ain't Madea Ghost Dutch. What are you saying, Rosetta Stone? But I do, I love him, but he doesn't speak a lot of English, but that's how I like to keep it, simple. He's spending so much time with me, his English is starting to sound like mine. He picked up the phone the other day, he was like, hey girl, hey. Guys, I married a European white guy that sounds like a gay black man. Thank you. I have been touched. By an angel. I do. I love him. And I love his family, too. They are super cute, but they are straight up, like, the whitest people I ever met. Like, they are one. Like, they wear matching sweaters and give calendars as presents. That's not a present. If I can get it for free on a magnet at a bank, it's not a present. Like, they're cute, but they all won't. Like, they go camping on purpose. I never felt like I was dating a white guy ever, real talk, until I had to go to the beach with his family. I'd never been to the beach with white European people before. Let me tell y'all something, they go prepared. They had sandwiches, organic teas, tents for little white babies. What? My people are Caribbean. We go to the beach with rum and condoms. Thank you guys very much. You've been so awesome.
You look great.
Thank you.
Michelle Buteau, everybody. We'll be right back.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
All right, Jeff, one more chapter, then you have to go to sleep.
Have you read that book, Larry King?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a great book.
What's it about?
About Larry King.
Does it say anything about the time he was in the mafia?
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
I didn't know either. I just made it up. But what if it was true?
I'm doing that thing where I laugh and don't move my mouth.
I noticed.
You think Larry's killed people?
No. Don't be absurd.
Oh, that's silly.
That'd be crazy. Do you think Secretariat's killed anyone?
No.
So you wanna walk home with me tonight?
How dare you?
What are you talking about?
I can't walk, man.
I was like, why would that? What's wrong with that? And then I remembered, you're stuck here till tomorrow.
Offer of help. That's great. You want me to help you? I mean, I can't walk. You're alone.
Sorry. So it's just going to be you left alone here tonight with Secretariat.
Maybe you could get me like a cart or something.
I'll get you a cart. Good night, everybody. Good night.